Hello everyone, this is Payal Bacha. Welcome to Pharma Desert. In this video, we will discuss about Drug and Cosmetic Act 1940, Part 5. Labeling and packaging. So labeling have two types. First of all, labeling in general case, and second one is labeling in special case. First of all, what is labeling in general or general labeling? Name of drug substance with its trade name or brand name. Example, paracetamol, IP tablets, metacin tablets, and name or synonym that is already specified in official pharmacopoeias like Indian pharmacopoeia and British pharmacopoeia. So in labeling general, name of any drug substance with its brand name, and that is the example paracetamol IP tablet and metacin tablet, and name or synonym that is already specified in any pharmacopoeias. Second one, what is the net content? First of all, drug or name of drug that is mentioned in all the labels. Second one, in label also mention net content, that means weight, volume or number of unit. In case of solid dosage form, that is weight, that is around 10 tablet. Second one, quantities of active ingredient expressed either in form of amount per single dose, that is around 5 ml, or in case of ml, particularly for oral liquids, if amount per milliliter, if parenteral dosage form, in amount per unit in case of tablet and capsule. So quantities of API that is expressed either in form of amount per single dose, that is around 5 ml for any oral preparation, amount per milliliter in case of parenteral dosage form, and amount per unit in case of tablet and capsule. Example, paracetamol IP tablet, that is 500 mg, and excipients, that is around quantity sufficient. Next one, what is the name and address of manufacturer and license number? So name and address of manufacturer, that is also mentioned, and license number is mentioned on labeling. So example, Themis Pharmaceutical, Vapi, Gujarat, that is the name and address of manufacturer, as well as license number, that is around G2102. That is the example of name and address of manufacturer. So first of all, in labeling or general labeling, first of all, what is required in general labeling? Name of drug substance, as well as quantity of drug substance, and name, as well as address of manufacturer, as well as license number, expiry date, batch number, manufacturing date, all are general labeling requirements. Remaining one, a distinctive batch number as well as lot number, that is also mentioned on labels. That is batch number, that is around 5, or lot number, that is around 6. While second one, date of manufacture and date of expiry, that is already mentioned on any label. And precautions information. What type of precaution information? Example, store in any dark place, otherwise store in cool place. All are the precautions, or any type of direction that is mentioned on label. And general information, like shake well before use. What is the direction, or what is the meaning of shake well before use? That means particularly shake well before use, that is used in case of suspension or emulsion. In a suspension and emulsion, solid dosage form that is settled down in any bottle or any container. So before using, that is shake properly, and after shaking, that is used. So that is used for external use only, and that is not to be sold if that is a physician sample. So if physician sample, that is not to be sold, right? In labeling special, if drug that is scheduled C1 or any biological drug product, so what is the special particular appeared on label, or what is the conditions that is write on a label? So first of all, proper name in addition to patient name, as well as name and address of manufacturer of final product. First of all, in schedule C1 drug, proper name, that is added to a patient name, as well as name and address of manufacturer, that is always already mentioned on final product. as well as license number, that is also mentioned. Expiry date, manufacturing date, that is also mentioned. And nature and percentage of antiseptic, if you are added. So what type of nature and how much amount of percentage of antiseptic added, that is already mentioned. And precautions for preservation, that is mentioned on particular in case of schedule DC1. If schedule H drug substance, so nature of medicine, that is around for internal use only and not in purview of narcotic substance. So if schedule H, that is schedule H for prescription related dosage form. And what is the nature of medicine? So that is used for internal use only. If schedule H drug substance, that is used for internal use only. So what is the special label? First of all, RX symbol, that is mentioned on left top corner of the label. As well as after RX symbol, mentioned schedule H drugs. And what is the warning? Warning, that is, it should be sold by retail on the prescription of registered medicinal practitioner only. That means schedule H drug, that is sell to any patient on the basis of prescription of registered medicinal practitioner. In schedule H drug, that is for internal use and falling in purview of narcotic substance. So schedule H, that is particularly internal use and if that is narcotic dosage form. So what is the change in symbol? Symbol, that is in first case, if that is internal use and that is not purview of narcotic, that means only RX that is necessary. But in case of internal use and that is falling on purview of narcotic, that means NRX for RX. RX that is common, but N that is for narcotic drug substance. And this type of symbol, that is mentioned on left top corner of label. And remaining conditions are same, that means schedule H drugs, as well as warning, that is it should be sold by retail on the prescription of registered medicinal practitioner only. Last one, schedule H drug substance, if you are using for internal or if you are using for external use only. So what is the label? In label, you have to mention external use only. Next one, administration of Act and Rules. So what is the administration of Act and Rules? First of all, advisory committee, that have two subtypes. Drug Technical Advisory Board, and second one, that is Drug Consultative Committee. Next one, Analytical Committee. In Analytical, that have already three types. Central Drug Laboratory, Drug Control Laboratory in any state, and Government Analyst. And third one, Executive Committee. First one, Licensing Authorities. Second one, controlling Authorities. And third one, that is Drug Inspector. So all the advisory board, analytical board and executive board, we will discuss briefly. First one, Drug Technical Advisory Board, or that are also called as DTAB, that have three members committee, ex officio, nominated and elected. First of all, in ex officio, first member, that is hired from Director General of Health Service or Director or Chairman of Health Service. Second one or second member, that is conducted from Drug Controller of India. Third member, that is conducted from Director of Central Drug Laboratory, that is available in Calcutta. And fourth member, that is hired from Director of Central Research Institute, Kaushali. Next member, Director of Indian Veterinary Research Institute, Izzat Nagar. Next member, that is hired from President of Medical Council of India, while remaining members are hired from President of Pharmacy Council of India, that is PCI, and Director of Central Drug Research Institute, Lucknow. So all are the ex officio members. Second one, nominated members. In nominated members, two person by central government from among person who are in charge of drug control in the state, while second one person by central government from the pharmaceutical industry. So in nominated committee, two person, that is hired from central government and from among person who are the directly in charge of drug controller in state. and one person that is from also that is from central government, and that is hired from pharmaceutical industry. Next one, third one, two persons which holding the appointment of government analyst under this act, and it should be nominated by central government. So remaining 2% that holding appointment of government analyst, as well as that is already nominated by central government. Next one, in elected members, one person to be elected by Executive Committee of Pharmacy Council of India from among teachers in pharmacy or pharmaceutical chemistry or pharmacognosy on the staff of Indian university or a college that is affiliated. So first one, one person that is directly elected by Executive Committee of Pharmacy Council of India, and that is from teacher in pharmacy. So one person that is directly elected from Executive Committee of PCI, and what is the teacher experience? So teacher have experience in pharmacy or pharmaceutical chemistry or pharmacognosy on the staff of an Indian university, otherwise a college that is affiliated. Second person or second member, it should be elected by Executive Committee of Medical Council of India from among the teachers in medicine or therapeutics on the staff of an Indian university or a college affiliated. So second person, it should be elected by Executive Committee of Medical Council of India, and teacher have experience in medicine or therapeutics on the staff of Indian university, otherwise college that is affiliated. Remaining members, one pharmacologist should be elected by governing body of Indian Council of Medical Research. So one member that is a pharmacologist, and that is directly elected from governing body of Indian Council of Medical Research, while one person that is elected from Central Council of Indian Medical Association, and last member, it should be elected by Council of Indian Pharmaceutical Association. So first committee, that is DTAB, Drug Technical Advisory Board, that is advice type of advisory board, and that have three committees, ex officio, nominated and elected members. What is the function of DTAB? To advise the central government and state government on technical matters arising out of administration of this act. So according to its name, Drug Technical Advisory Board, they directly advise to central government as well as state government on any technical matters that is directly arising from administration of act, and any type of modification and amendment in this act with that is permittable with consultation of board, and it carried out other functions that is directly assigned to it by this act. And the nominated and elected members of board, they shall hold office for 3 years but shall be eligible for re-nominated and re-election. So nominated and elected member of DTAB board, they hold office for 3 years, but after 3 years, it should be eligible for re-nomination as well as they are re-elected. Second one, or second committee or advisory committee, that is Drug Consultative Committee, that is also one type of advisory board, and that is directly constituted by central government. So what is the constitution? First one, two representative of central government and one representative of each state government. So a constitution that is made up of two representative of central government, while one representative of state government. To advise the central government, state government and DTAB on any other matters tending to secure uniformity throughout the India in the administration of act. So what is the function of CDL? So function that is, they directly advise central government as well as state government, and that also advise DTAB on any other matters that is directly tending to secure uniformity of act throughout the India. So Drug Consultative Committee, that they shall meet when required, has power to regulate its own procedure. Next one, CDL, Central Drug Laboratory, that is the analytical board. So that is established in Calcutta under the control of director, that is appointed by central government. So central drug laboratory, that is established in Calcutta, and that is under the control of director, and this director, that is directly appointed by central government. So what is the functions of central drug laboratory? Analysis or testing of samples of drug or cosmetic that is directly sent by custom collector or the court. So analysis or testing of sample of drug or cosmetic that is sent to court. And analytical quality control of imported samples, that is second function, quality control of any imported samples or dosage form. And last one, collection, storage and distribution of internal standards. That is all about Central Drug Laboratory. It is established in Calcutta and that is appointed by central government. One type of director or any person that is appointed by central government. Remaining functions, preparation of reference standard and their maintenance. So reference standard, it should be prepared and that is mentioned, maintained properly. Maintenance of microbial culture, as well as any other duties that is entrusted by central government. So maintain the microbial culture by performing any quality control test or quality analysis. And last one, acting as an appellate authority in matter of any dispute. So if any dispute that is occur, that is act as an appellate authority. If any query or doubts related to topic, please write your question in comment box. Thank you.